found it.
Virginia Barrel Classic bound. Right now we were at a rest stop because Mike had to go to the bathroom, but we were actually almost there. We're like an hour away, but we left this morning, and unfortunately today this whole weekend it's just gonna be Ember and I running. Allie was supposed to come this weekend, but she had an accident with her leg, and
everybody's gotta use the bathroom sometime.
I'm good, thank you.
My wife's busy. Pickle pie
pictures.
Yeah, my princess. And that's my queen.
But anyway, so yeah, we're almost there. Allie can't make it, so she had something happen over this past weekend. She has to get her leg looked at, and she's the one. She had an incident with her leg years ago, so she has like plates and screws and everything in it. So she can't come, unfortunately. But it's Ember and I. There's their trailer right there. And I'm running Friday, Saturday, Sunday. She's going to run Friday, Saturday. Today, she's going to exhibition this afternoon. I exhibition tomorrow morning. But we're going to get there, get the horse settled in, get everything figured out. And then we'll get on later this evening. She'll exhibition. I'll just ride Boo around. So we'll see how this week goes. Super excited. I'm hoping for another repeat of last year's. Last year was amazing. And Boo is feeling really, really good coming off of Sunday's race. She's head off. Just take it easy and everything. So we'll see what happens when we get down there. I'm super excited to see everybody, see some of my sponsors, including Driven's going to be there. And it's going to be a fun weekend. So we'll see what happens. And I'm excited because this is Ember's first big barrel race. So it's going to be a lot of fun for everybody. So today's been a busy day. We're just getting done, starting to wind down. Boo's getting her dinner right now. And she didn't expo today, but we did ride around. Ember had some gorgeous exhibitions, which are right here. She handled this so good. And I'm so proud of how her and Dallas are doing everything. They've never been in a setting like this before, so it's new to both of them. And they both went in there and had probably their best exhibition yet. And I even had a little catch ride on my friend's horse that is a Frenchman's guy and had a lot of fun on her. Never sat on this horse before and just kind of cruised her through just to work on a few things and see some things with her. And I actually had a blast. She's a super, super nice mare. And again, my friend's done such a good job with her. So here I am with that horse here. So we're mostly settled in. We are waiting for my friend Tiffany to come with RJ that you guys have seen before, who owned Hollywood. And we are starting to wind down. I said everyone's getting their dinner. Everyone's kind of running to town to get food so we can eat later. And we're just going to kind of chill today. Tomorrow, Boo and I will exhibition first thing in the morning. We're going to expo at 8. We're going to do 3 just to get in there, see things out. And we don't run till Friday. So once tomorrow morning comes around and we get done with that, it's a pretty chill day and we'll see how everything goes, but it's beautiful weather and we have a great stall spot. I like being out here because fresh air and so we'll see how everything goes and just chill out the rest of the weekend and or rest of the night. And everyone's settling in great and doing good. So all's good here and I can't wait for tomorrow. So good morning. It is almost 7. We're out for a little walk. You see Boo's trucking along. As always, we went out for a little walk and then we were going to get on probably about a half hour to do our expos. And we're done for the day. Ember did hers last night, so she's all set for the day. And basically once we're done riding, she's done for the day until we have to walk around a lot later. But at least today will be a quick early morning, so everyone gets settled in and still trailers are still pulling in at 3 o'clock this morning when I have to do checks. So right now, doing a brisk morning stroll, and then we'll see how these expos go. I'll see you guys later. So today is Friday and today is our first race day. I am draw 250 and Ember is 238. Right now, we're just going for a little walk. Our first morning walk. Then she'll go get some laser therapy, go over her with a massage gun, make sure she's not tight anywhere. She just got worked on yesterday, so she hopefully shouldn't. And we'll see how today goes. So today starts off with the peewees and there's like 60 something peewees. So we really won't know what time we run until they do. Because it could be quick, it could be slow. And they're doing the first 1 through 400, and they're doing a break for the high stakes slot race, and then finishing it out. So it's gonna be a late night. I've never seen it so packed here before. There's no trailer parking anywhere. People are still rolling in, and like, let me flip this. Like, there's the hill where usually everyone parks, and there's not even enough room. People parking at the arenas now. Like, literally everyone's just jamming trailers where they can to stay because there's not enough room. So it's massive. But today will be a fun day. It's going to be nice too because Allie, unfortunately, cannot come because she's severely injured. And she's pretty upset by it, but she's going to come down today to watch us and support us and get out of the house for a little bit. So it's going to be a fun day. We'll see how today goes. But it's another beautiful morning. It's feeling very fresh. Majestic. Look at that mane blow in the wind. So majestic. So I literally am speed walking to keep up with her. But it's going to be a fun day. Let's see how everything happens today. Hopefully we have a nice clean run and just have fun.
Position 238. Ticket number 238. Fire, breathing, Dallas. Taking us over to John Nittany.
Come on, get after! Good! Nice, go!
How about you, fellas?
There you go!
Dragon 250.
Get her, get her!
Numbers were in at 250 to a 5868, 158. And we return to
'Yesterday was such an amazing day. I look exhausted, by the way. It is Saturday morning. My eyes are so swollen. I look exhausted. Who's not? Who's marching? And yesterday was the best run of my life. And I literally had no words to say. I didn't even know how to vlog because I was just so proud of how she ran. And we ran our first 15. So we've never ran a 15 before, let alone at a place this big. And I literally was just, everyone was crying. Like, everyone that knew us was crying. People in the stands, people in the crew. It was just an amazing, amazing run and day. And everyone did really, really good. So we ran a 15.8. And then Ember had run just before me with her first big run on Dallas. They also had another amazing run. I was so proud of them. Ember had so much fun. She was so cute because she was like super excited and nervous. And I've never seen her nervous before, so it was really fun to watch. But they handled it so well. Mike had to help them get in just because I was two drags after her with Boo. So I kind of warmed her up, watched her run, helped her, and got ready to run. But everyone did so amazing yesterday. It was a long day, which is why I think I also half forgot to vlog, because I don't know what time the open finished last night. I went back to the trailer to try to wind down. I tried to wash my hair in the cold freezing showers, and I don't remember what time it was by the time I fell asleep. I fell asleep watching it, and I missed one of my friend's runs. But they had 250 in the slot race. That did not end until super late. And then my friend was like 6 something, and I want to say it was like 1:30 before I fell asleep. And they still hadn't run yet, and they still had horses to run. So yesterday was a very, very long day. I still have like no voice, I think, from screaming from everybody. And, but it was just so amazing. Like, I literally had no words yesterday with how proud I was of her. It was just such a huge accomplishment for us to finally break the 15s. And yeah, you want to tell everyone about it, Boo? Tell everyone how you did. She's feeling good this morning. She's marching. She laid down and slept really good last night, despite it being a late night. So this morning they started off with the American contender. And it was so cute yesterday too, because like one of my goals is to enter a slot race at some point. And granted, the slot race here is like super competitive, but even with our time, everyone's like, okay, why didn't you enter? Because like you might have had a shot at something. I was like, yeah, if you won't pay my entry fees, I will. But, no, it was a great, great day. And today they do the American. There's over 800 something also under today. I think there's Last I checked yesterday, it was like 860 something. I don't know how many is today. But we run 346, I think. So we're actually top of drag today. Oh, mind you, Boo doesn't like bottom drag. Yesterday we were last in the drag before the big drag. Like very, very last horse before the big drag. And she ran that. So also kudos to her. But yeah, today we're like, I think, top drag. We're 346, I think. It's gonna be another late night because Ember is 8:23. So she probably won't run till midnight. But we're all kind of a little slow moving this morning. But yep, so we're just out for a walk right now. Then we'll get our colts off, go graze, and see how today goes. I hope we can keep this momentum going. I even said yesterday, I said, I don't care how the rest of the weekend goes. The fact that we had a run like that, had a good first and ran a 15.8, I'm ecstatic. So I'm hoping for a repeat today. Now, especially now that I know Boo has it in her. So I hope we just keep this momentum going and it just gets better and better from here. So we'll see how it goes.
Across the line, 17902, 17902, and 2.
Wow, so happy Sunday, everybody. I'm exhausted, if you can't tell. My face is so swollen. Going off of 3 hours of sleep and 4 hours the night before, but all for good reason. So yesterday, Boo and I ran earlier in the day, and not only did we have a really good clear run, we also beat our time from Saturday with a 15.7. So I was ecstatic with her. Cried. I sobbed. And not gonna lie, going into yesterday's run, I wasn't doubting ourselves, but you know when you have those really good runs and you don't remember what happened, and that's how Saturday felt or Friday's felt. And so I like really didn't know what I did. And like looking back at the video, I was like, well, I just rode and we did good, but it wasn't like going there. I was like, oh, I rode her to here and did this and did that. And it just felt so surreal that I was actually thinking like, well, maybe this was just a fluke. Maybe the ground was just that fast. Maybe just all the stars aligned. So I didn't know what to expect yesterday. But I went there to make a run. and she beat her time. So I lost it. But it was a really, really good run. I was ecstatic with her. She felt amazing. Our first was better. She got a little bit past the second, but she just kept on going. So it was a really, really great day. And a bunch of my friends ran kind of shortly after that. But then Ember was 8:23 out of 900 and something horses. So Ember literally did not run until 1 o'clock this morning. And I was joking around because this is her first big show. I was like, of course, like, the show gods would be like, here's the full experience of going to these big shows and not sleeping and running very, very late. So she ran at 1 o'clock this morning, did great. They beat their time from yesterday. Dallas handled it like a pro. And we also didn't know kind of what to expect from her. Dallas, not Ember. Because again, this horse has been to places before, but I really don't think she's been to this caliber of an event. And having to run at 1 o'clock in the morning is hard for these horses sometimes. So, she handled it really good. Sorry, I'm kind of winded now because we've been walking. As always, Boo's on a mission, checking along up and down the hills. But, she handled like a pro. They had an amazing run. Thing I say I love about Ember is I literally tell her, I'm like, you need to try to do this and that. And she goes out there and does it. And her Friday run, she got a little wide on that backside of the second. I told her today, so get her nose and hold on to them. Make her finish that turn. And she did. And it was so, so good. So it really, really made a big difference for them. And I was just ecstatic with how they did. Then my friend, who I fell asleep five horses before, the night before, ran at 8:70 something. So then of course I was like, well, I'm already up. Might as well stay up and watch. Because she runs late today and I'm not going to be here today. Once we run, we are done and we are leaving. Oh my God. This is such a big hill. Mind you, these vlogs don't do justice. I'm tired. And now you're chugging along, which is great. Oh, jeez. Okay. So yesterday was amazing. And I could not have been happier with how Ember and Dallas did and how Boo did. She was literally blowing me away this weekend. And things are just starting to click. I don't know. It's weird. Like Friday felt fast and it just felt really good. But then yesterday just felt like we've been doing it for forever. And it was such a different feeling. Even when I looked up at the time, I saw the 15 and I saw the 9. I was like, oh my God, at least we ran a 15 again. And then I didn't realize there was a 7 in front of the 9. It's like, oh my God, we beat our time. So it was a good day. We are draw 400 and something today. We're not running until like 4 o'clock this afternoon and then we leave. So it's gonna be a long day. We won't be home till late. And right now Boo's coming up for her morning walk, getting some grass, stretching her legs. She'll get cleaned up and all her therapies this morning. And yeah, we'll run a bit later. So it's been amazing so far. And I'm sorry, the vlogs have been all over the place. I look back and probably edit these and want you guys to watch these, but really by the end of the day is, but we've been up so late and running and then getting her taken care of and everyone else running and all the things. So I just find it easier, better to do it in the morning when it's just me and her going out for our morning strolls, her half dragging me around the facility. And so you guys can kind of see. So that big indoor behind me is where we run that one right there. If you've never been here before. So Boo likes to graze at the very, very top of this hill. And there's all the way down to the bottom of the hill. But so we'll see how today goes. I'm just so ecstatic over the weekend. I really have no expectations of today besides I'm just so happy to be where we're at and have things clicking into place. And I feel like we're really, I don't know what happened this weekend, but we've really just feels like we're there and it feels really, really good. Right, Mama? Yeah. Boo's like, I know, I'm the best. But so we'll see how today goes and fingers crossed we have another great smoke and run.
There you go, push her, push her. Get around there. Yeah, get. Come on, come on.
Stop the numbers at a 16-3-1-4-1-6-3-1-4.
We are back home. Everyone is eating breakfast. I slightly slept in today, because we actually didn't get back terribly late last night, but it was a long day. But we had, Boo had another clean run. We're getting ready to take her poultice off. Boo had another clean run. Getting ready, when Mike came over, I literally said, like, I don't know this energy she has, if it was a good thing or a bad thing, joking around, because she felt good. She felt very good. She was just very strong, I guess to say, but not, like, she just had this different air. And I didn't know if it was a good thing or a bad thing. And did her normal warm up and let her go. And granted, looking back at our run, it wasn't as terrible, as I guess, as I originally thought. It felt all over the place. It wasn't as all over the place, I guess, as I thought it was. She did get past the first and the second, made up for it at the third. But I think she just went in there very ready to run. And we're joking, like, maybe she's probably just getting cocky now, because she's running 15s, and she's like, yeah, we can do this. But I think part of it was that she was feeling really good, even though it was her third day, really strong, ready to run. I think I missed my timings a little bit, because she went in there so powerful, and I wasn't really expecting that. So we blew past the first, blew past the second, which she never does, so that's how you know we were just, like, doing whatever. Picked up third, and even though despite blowing past the first and second, we still ran a 16.3. It was out of the money. Of course, they rolled the times from Saturday to Sunday. So the 14.4 that won it on Saturday won it on Sunday, which mixed feelings about that. A lot of us were talking about that, but I'm not going to bash the classic or anything about that. But I'm just very curious as to what the fastest time physically ran yesterday was. Some of us felt the ground was a little bit slower. So like if a 14.4 won it Saturday, maybe a 14.5 would have won it on Sunday. I don't know. We don't know these things, but I'm just curious what the actual fastest time run of that day was. And it was a good day. We ran late. We ran around like between 4 and 5. We got home, I want to say 10:30, but it was just a long week and it was a lot of fun. Boo is settling in great being back home. Reba is exhausted. Reba, you tired? We're all kind of tired. Like I said, I'm feeding late. Because I told work today, I wish I took off today, but I told him, I was like, I'm coming in, I'm going to be late. So, yeah. So, now we're just going to kind of recoup the next couple of days. Boo's going to have some time, not, I hate to say some time off, but she's going to have a couple days off. Just to kind of chill and relax, get some therapies later and some spoilings. And, we have a race on Saturday, so I'm debating to bring her. I haven't decided yet. Part of me says, screw it, let's bring her. She's feeling good this weekend. But I'm going to see how she feels throughout the week. If she's really tired from this long trip, I won't. But if she feels like she's ready to run and ready to go, then we'll run on Saturday again, one of my favorite pens. So we'll see how this week goes. But yesterday was super successful. Everyone did good this weekend. It was such a great weekend with all my friends. And everyone really had amazing runs and improved on their personal best times and everything like that. So it was a great, great weekend. We're just on super horse show hangover. I got my ZOA shirt on because I am going to be exhausted and living off ZOA for the next couple days. But yeah, so it was a great weekend. And we will see if we can keep the, now that we kind of broke that ice running into the 15s, I'm hoping we can keep this going. And we've kind of unlocked a new thing together. Right, girl?
So see you guys later. Yeah.